guess I thought I'd be trying different settings and potentially burning food to work out how to use the Satisfry's Sear Mode as an electric frying pan. I went for Lidl's very affordable Scottish breakfast pack for this experiment. The ingredients for a big Scottish breakfast can vary, but ideally it will include most of the following: square lawn sausage, link sausages, fried egg, streaky bacon, baked beans, black pudding and or haggis, tatty scones, fried tomatoes and mushrooms, toast and potatoes. The Lidl pack gets close, but I added eggs, potato cakes, mushrooms, tomatoes and potatoes and gave the streaky bacon, baked beans and toast a miss this time. My assumption here is that if the bottom of the cooking pot gets sufficiently hot to sear food, then with a bit of oil in there, it should happily fry food as well. With the Satisfry, there is the challenge of not being able to see the food frying all the time, as it cuts power to the heating element when the lid is lifted due to the sensor switch under the cooking pot. I found that this was not a big problem. Default settings for Sear Mode are 230 degrees for 10 minutes, which I guess simply means the element is turned up to maximum. I left the default temperature at 230 degrees and this worked perfectly, and initially I set the time for 25 minutes as a best guess, but in the end I didn't need that long. I turned everything over after every 1 minute of cook time. I allowed the cooking pot to heat up for 3 minutes before throwing in any ingredients. First the potatoes to give them a head start, and then after 2 minutes I added the meat. After another 4 minutes I added the mushrooms and tomatoes. 1 minute later I cracked a couple of eggs in there, and after 2 minutes everything was cooked to my taste. By luck rather than judgment, nothing was over or undercooked and nothing got burned. So there you have it, the Satisfry is also capable of delivering a big fried breakfast in about 12 minutes. It's all good.